Lights, camera, action.
In this video, I will simply explain how to read a number from the console. So the user will enter a value on the terminal, and that value will be automatically saved to a variable. For the code, I will only read an integer value, and I will write the code in the function main. So to get the user input, I will print to the console a message asking him to give a value. I will read that value and then print it out to check if the value was correctly stored. I will use only the function main. I will declare my variable of type int because I want to first read an integer value. Then I will print a message to the user asking him to give a number, for example. Then I will read that value from the console using the scanf function. So since it's an integer, I will use the %d format, and I will store that value in the address of the variable n. Then I will print it out to check if the value was correctly saved. Printed value equal to percent format d again, and the value n. Now I can check it out. I give a number 25, and the dot value is equal to 25. It was correctly stored. In the next code, we will read a value of type float. To do this, we have to make some changes in the code.
Now, if I want to read the float value, I will have to change the type of the variable or declare another one. For example, here float. In the printing, I will in the reading, I will read using %f instead of %n. Same for the printing. If I run it now, give a number 25, same as the integer one. It will add by default 6 digits after the decimal point. To avoid this, I can specify a format, for example, saying print out only 2 digits after the decimal number. Now, if I give the same number, it will only print 2 digits. If you found the video useful, you can wait for the next one where I explain how to get sync input.